We have 12 mascots out here, and in order to kick the whole thing off, we have the voice of the Chip Champion Challenge, the legendary Detroit broadcaster, Eli Zarrett.
Thank you, Bill. Got a lot of great career highlights, and I'm proud to say, although this isn't one of them, I'm very happy to be here as the host of the 6th annual. And, you know, Bill Harrington has criticized me for years. I continually forget the entire name. And now you are guilty, sir, because it isn't just the Uncle Ray's Chip Challenge. It's the Uncle Ray's Potato Chips Chip Champion Challenge, or as we like to say, the UPC CCC Challenge. So let's get the mascots out here so I can introduce you one by one. Let's get out here in your position so people can take a good look at you. And we're going to go through the intros of that have. We'll see if we can get a new champion perhaps this year, because this event has been dominated by one particular mascot who everybody is gunning for this year. But let's start with a newcomer to the Chip Challenge. He hails from Lawrence Tech. It is Blue. Let's hear it for Blue. Blue making his first appearance. Can he win the first time around? Got many mascots here from the new United Shore League. Let's hear it from the representing the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. It's Buzz. Where's Buzz? There's Buzz at the end. Let's hear it for Buzz. I guess we're saving our real applause for the former champions. Let's get a little more enthusiasm here, crowd. Because from the Detroit Sports Commission, making yet another appearance, looking for his first victory, is Champ. Here's Champ. Look at that pompadour. Woo! Fabulous. Okay, and another new entrant from Rocket Fiber. He is Commander G. Igabit. G. Igabit. Carrying some little weight there in the back. I don't know if it's going to affect the balance of his swing or not. Another one from the United Shore League. He is from the Utica Unicorns. It's Lancelot. Where's Lancelot? Here he is. All right, Lancelot. And again, looking for his first victory, a participant every year. He is back to give it another try for the Detroit Tigers. It's Paws. Let's hear it for Paws. Again, from the United Shore League, the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. It's Ribby. Where's Ribby? He was here last year looking for his victory. Yeah, big crowd here. And from the University of Detroit Mercy, Tommy Titan returns to try again. Come on, Tommy Titan, maybe he'll break through into the winner's circle this year. Again from the United Shore League, from the West Side Woolly Bandits, it's Woolly. Here's Woolly. Here's Woolly. All right, Woolly. And now we get into our former champions. Like we say, this is the 6th. There's been 5 champions crowned so far, but just 3 who have been able to win. And the winner of the inaugural 2013 Uncle Ray's Potato Chips Challenge comes from the University of Oakland, or Oakland University, and it is Grizz, the 2013 champion Grizz. He won in 2015. He thought he'd come back and defend the last 2 years, but he's fallen just short, but back to try and win his second title at the Chip Champion Challenge is Sparty. Sparty, looking really good in warm-ups today with Sparty. And here is the man who was dominated, the mascot who was dominating this competition. He won in 2014. He has won with both the golf balls and he has won with the tennis balls. Is there any format where he can be defeated? We'll see if this might be the year. I'm talking about the 2014, the 2016, and the 2017 champion, Rory. There's Rory. And we are privileged once again for to have a referee. He has refereed over 100 championship fights. He is Detroit's eminent boxing aficionado. He is Frank Garza. Bring Frank Garza out here, who will now give the rules and some very terse warnings to our participants to keep it clean. Okay, gather around. Go, Frankie, what do you got to tell them?
Well, first of all, I got to call Rory up here. There's been a question. I just want to give Rory, I apologize.
Steroids? No, no, no.
No, no, no. We got to do this.
Let me see.
Okay.
No razor blades?
No razor blades.
No. Okay, guys, he's clean. He's clean. We've already went over all the rules in the dressing room. Let's have a good, clean chip. I want no dip chip.
Chip dip, but that's okay.
Chip dip. Try saying that 3 times real fast.
We only get one shot, right? Only one shot, so make it count.
Closest to the pin is the winner. All right, so let's go.
Let's go. All right. Mascots, get back at your marks. Where's our referee? Well, Frank's the referee here. Okay, Frank. We're going to try right. Do we have a measuring tape or anything like that? Or we just eyeballing this thing. You're eyeballing this thing?
All right.
Here we go. First up, in order of appearance will be, as they were introduced, it'll be Lawrence Hicks Blue. Here's Blue. What's pressure on Blue? He's the first one up, first tip challenge. Looks confident. Let's see what Blue can do.
All right, crowd is hush. Two fools over the ball. I think he's got a slightly off the pitch here. Practice here. Look at that. Look at that.
Ooh, looks a little long. Checks up, but don't think that'll hold up. Let's just keep that one there. Okay.
All right, a small pairing across the blue. Not a bad first effort at all. And now for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers, here's Buzz. Buzz. Need a club, Buzz. Oh, that's okay. All right, with the yellow ball.
Oh, it's going to come up a little short. All right, still leading is Blue after one round. Frank, would you pick up that ball there? Because that could get in somebody's way. And from the Detroit Sports Commission, next up is Champ. Let's hear it for Champ. Come on, Champ. Oh, keep going, keep going. Another little short, a little chunky. Okay, let's get that one out of the way. Still leading is Blue. Blue is still there. Now another first time here making his initial appearance from Rocket Fiber. It's Commander G Igabit. Woo! Slight of build. You can actually see. Whoa, is he from the line? Oh, violation! Violation! Serious violation. Nope, not kicking in front of the bucket. First timer. He can get away with this stuff. Come on. Come on here. Do you think we are? Does he think this is our first kick challenge? What the hell? Oh, that little battery pack at his back seemed to restrict his swing. Little push to the right. So, Igabit gets a no applause for Igabit. My goodness, not even a little. All right, and now for the Utica Unicorns, it's Lancelot. Lancelot's next up, all right. Still holding up is Blue, about 10 feet, 10, 12 feet. He's playing it safe, he's 10 feet behind, that's okay. Oh, got a little behind that, yes. You know, he peeked a little bit there and pushed it to the right, which is unfortunate. He's new at this. Practice for hours, too. What a shame to see that happen. Here we go. For the Detroit Tigers, it's Paws. He's been here every year. Let's see if he can go 1 for 6.
Time out.
The average of bottom half of his order. Oh, pulled it a little bit down the left field line, just foul. What do we think, Frank? We got to measure this one off. Where the heck is the measuring stick? Oh, very imprecise. We could take larger steps. 12, 13, 4, 6, 8, 3, 9. What do you got there? How many? 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Blue is still going to have it. Is that 14 or 13?
12.
12, okay. Blue stays in at 12. Okay, and now another United Shore League mascot from the East Side Diamond Hoppers. Diamond Hoppers, let's hear it for Ribby.
Pause, excuse me, you've been eliminated. I just want to be really active. Okay. Think back of the line. This is golf. You're supposed to police yourself. Hear me. Give me a target. Oh, it's going. It's rolling. It's rolling. I don't know. That looks not quite. What do you think? No? Is it clearly? Okay. About a foot short. Not a bad effort. And now, from the University of Detroit Mercy, here's Tommy Titan. Tommy Titan looking for his first victory. Been here every year.
See what Tommy's got this year. Yep. Okay, he's got it lined up. Good stance. Good. Down in the middle. Good line.
Ooh. Go. No, it checks up. Nobody's going for the roll. Nobody with a little low liner. They're all trying to pop it in there and come up a little short. Who would have ever thought that Blue's first effort would still hold up? And we're coming up to number 9 of 12 in the after the West Side Woolly Mammoths. Woolly, here's Woolly. It's all former champions from here on in are going to take a shot at Blue. Here we go. West Side Woolly. Strong roll of half. You can really leverage when you're going to lend. Oh, could be good. Keep going. Keep another one coming up just short, I think. Just short. Yeah. I don't think you're going to, I don't think you're 12 there.
That's
how you referee fights. Just like
7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Oh, he's
12 and a half. He's that much short.
That much short. Okay. Unless your feet have grown in the last few minutes. All right, that was pretty close. And now, the stat bottom of the order. Let's hear it for the 2013 champion, Grizz from Oakland U. And Grizz breaking the winner's circle again. He's had a little taste of victory, but it's been 5 years now. Oh, Grizz. Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. He tried the ground ball technique, but short again. And we're down to just 2. Blue, what do you think your chances are, Blue? You feeling good about it? Thumbs up for Blue. We got Sparty, though. Here's Sparty. Come on, Sparty. 2015 was your year. Come on, let's get back in there. I think your team had a pretty good year that year.
Yeah,
come on. Good practice, good follow through. Here he goes. Oh, turn right. I think he has it. I think he has it. I think Sparty's in there. Definitely Sparty's in there by a good margin. 1, 2, 3. He's like a 10, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wipe his gloves off. He's back in there. 9, 9 and a half. Sparty, now in first place. Don't celebrate too soon, Sparty. You see what happens when that happens. Come on now. Start celebrating. My God. Like Michigan did at that awful game 2 or 3 years ago. Here we go. Here's Rory. Let's give a round of applause for Rory. Could he actually make it 4 out of 6? The unprecedented. Here we go.
He's got the Lions colors.
He's got the blue ball. Little wind, little slight wind in his face. Look at that. The swagger, the confidence. Look at him. A model of golfing excellence. Yeah. And over the ball. Eyes deflect. Check it out one more time just to make sure. Gonna go a little left to right, Rory. Gonna go left to right. Bottom line. It's up. It looks pretty good. A little check up. He's been it again! He's the undisputed champion, Rory! All right, yes! Congratulations, Rory! Fabulous. And now to present the winner's trophy is Trevor Thompson, the president of the Detroit Sports Media. Come on, mascots. Give it a little support. There you go. What good-natured mascots. Way to go, Rory. I tell you, man. And you checked him, right? You checked him. Did you give him a blood test? You didn't give him a blood test, though.
Rory, very, very impressive. You're clutch, you're consistent, and you are, once again, a champion. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. We'll see you again next year for the 7th annual Uncle Ray's Potato Chip Champion Challenge. Here are your participants this year. Let's hear it for all of them and another great show. All right, guys.
Wait, hold on.